Alright, so we're following my buddy Rory here, trying to figure out some better lines. He races Dora on Hare Scramble. So that's what I'm going to be doing, is studying where he's going, smoother lines than me. To be honest, I'm not even thinking about smoother lines. But if I need a pass or something, I need to find alternate lines. Or even let faster guys by. This is our second lap in, by the way, so we already did a lap. Make sure there's nothing on the trail. Only one down tree. Different, we'll see, but this is real tight, so we'll see later on. Like back there, I'm thinking if I cut through that tree and straight line it, maybe a little faster. Oh, so I gotta pay attention. We back the pace off, can't let your guard down though. That's how stupid mistakes happen. He's on a 2001 CR125, by the way. I'd love to find a route around that. That route slows you down so much. That little section's fun. Tight turns, you gotta be quick, like chicanes. Ooh, straight to the face. Oh, see, Rory, you don't take that line up the wall. Smoother. I thought about this, but there's that tree. Oh, yes, yes. Never took that line, that's good. The sun is blinding me through the trees here. Thank you. That one whoop is getting real big, so that's a good one. There's that big log. I was thinking about going straight there. I don't think I said it, but even though we're going a pretty good pace, they go up the wall. We're going a pretty good pace first lap. Got around here in 28:15. Again, I have my watch set. I have my watch set to pause if we stop, just to wait for each other. I gotta remember to back off in the mud puddle, so. My gear will wait up. Sucks. It's getting so deep. Big ass ruts. Gear, didn't mean to do that. Alright, so the other difference is first lap, I didn't crank down those straightaways. We were just doing 68 kilometers. I catch back up here. So one thing I noticed on the top end now, you guys know I changed my crank pressure sensor, and I did a little leaning out of the bike. Feels much better, much crisper off the bottom actually. So how's that? Little breakup. At the very, very bottom, but cleaner everywhere else. But I just noticed down that straightaway. Oh. Just noticed down that straightaway that maybe getting used to the power is time to turn out that power valve a little more. Give me more of a hit. Oh, that hurt right to the mug. Yeah. Oh, look, he doesn't know about this hotline. Oh, Rory. Ooh, there's a line on the outside there. I gotta figure out how to line to hit it, though. A little off balance. So if you didn't hear him, he was just saying that's where he hit his head off that tree. That's gotta hurt, because you go quick through there. Ah, not too bad, because that root though. Oh! He's here to show me lines, guys! What happened? Here's another one. Yeah, he knows this one.
Yeah.
today. Alright, so fun fact, coming through here, Rory's followed me a bunch of times. This section, he always catches me. I just hear his bike all the time, so yeah, he just carries a lot more speed through here. Of almost crashing. I just leaned it too much and I lost my balance. Oh, I should have shown that line. There's a line right here. Took the outside line there last time, I didn't like it as much.
Yeah.
out of the corner. Becoming a handful at my normal throttle application. I like it. Or maybe I'm just riding a little more aggressive. Up on that jump. This turn right here has to come in way too hot. You just basically come to a standstill. It's one of those slow in, fast out turns.
Yeah.
turn sneaky. There's two trees waiting to take you out right there on the entrance. I'm learning is, if you don't know or you don't remember a turn, probably better off going in a little slower than you think in case it tightens up. Like this is blind. I don't know if it comes across on camera, but you can't see that turn coming up at all. I don't know if I can see it. Hold on. We just got to do a little math. 56:14. What'd I say? 28?
Yeah, 28.
28 something. I remember the seconds.
What'd you say? 54?
56:14.